in the worst mood. P1 cleaner than your church shoes. Really point to just to hurt you. All red lamp just to tease you. None of these toys on lease to. Made your whole year in a week to. Main bitch out of your league to. Side bitch out of your league to. House so empty, need a centerpiece. 20 racks of table come from ebony. Cut that ever into skinny pieces.
And dudettes, welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to the vlog, guys. So today's video is all about the slide tackle, mastering the slide, the basics, the fundamentals, what you should and shouldn't do, and also some different variations of the slide as well. So without further ado, let's go and begin today's video. All right, guys, so here we go here. I'm gonna talk about some of the key points regarding slide tackling, things I always kind of look out for before I actually perform a slide tackle. Now, there's a lot of variations of slide tackling, but the majority of the points I'm about to cover right now cover the majority of slide tackles, if that makes sense. So the first point is make sure the attacker is sprinting and he's not jogging. Now, it's very hard to time a tackle right when the attacker is jogging because it can easily cut the ball back or just stop the ball and have you go flying across or flying through him. So it's very hard to time a tackle right when the attacker is jogging. So make sure he's sprinting because it's just more predictable to time a tackle. So the first point is make sure he is sprinting and not jogging. Key point number two is look for big ball pushes. So this is one I focus on a lot in high school because there's not a lot of players at that age, at that level, that have mastered their dribbling yet. So they have a big ball push, and that means I'm gonna dive in because the ball, when it rolls, is more predictable than it is if it's by the player's foot. So look for big ball pushes from your opponent because that just means it's easier to time a tackle and get it right and not hurt the player in the process of your tackle. So key point number two is look for big ball pushes. Key point number three is look how the ball is being presented to you. So if you're on his right side, the opponent's right side, and he's dribbling with his right foot, it's a lot easier to win the ball in comparison if the ball is being dribbled on the opponent's left foot and you're on his right side. So just always kind of gauge and look how the ball is being presented to you because that just determines your odds of winning the ball and not hurting the player and hurting yourself and causing a foul. So key point number three is look how the ball is being presented to you on the pitch. Key point number four is understand your strengths, your weaknesses, what you can and cannot do on the pitch, your positive attributes, your negative attributes, as that builds your confidence on the pitch. And that confidence leads to commitment, and that commitment leads to winning balls. So understand your strengths and weaknesses and base those attributes off sliding in or not, because if you hesitate in the pitch, guys, in regards to slide tackling, that causes a lot of injuries and chances are on goal for the opponent. So make sure you guys know your strengths and weaknesses as that builds the commitment level you need to win ball. So that is key point number four, is commitment. Key point number five is all about the risk versus the reward, if the challenge is worth it or if it's not worth it. And the pros and cons of each challenge you do perform plays off very fast in your mind. So understanding that and understanding your strengths and weaknesses as a player are very, very hard to do in a quick period of time. And that's almost harder to do than actually performing the slide tackle, because after you guys learn the slide tackle, it's pretty straightforward, pretty easy to perform on the pitch. But understanding the pros and cons of each tackle you give is the hard part. So understanding the risks versus the rewards is crucial in your success on the pitch. But that is key point number five, is the risk versus the reward. But moving on to the first tackle, and that is the basic. All right, so the first challenge, first tackle, is the basic. It's probably one of the most well-receptive tackles there is in football because it's just so easy to win the ball when the form is right. But I think this is what most people imagine when they imagine a slide tackle, is the basic, because it's just so common and just so classy when done right. But the form of the basic is as follows. So for this example, I'll be sprinting in the same direction as my opponent on his right shoulder, using my right foot to challenge and win the ball. But my left leg is going to be used underneath me as a balancing tool and guiding tool, as a cushion to help me win the ball as well. So just make sure that your left leg is tucked underneath you and you're sliding in your left hip and not right hip. And my right leg is going to be fully extended with my right foot extended as well to help me win the ball. So again, the form is left leg underneath you, sliding in your left hip. Your right leg is somewhat bent, actually, because you don't want to have that contact, if you are contacting his leg, to have it really snap back. So small bend in your right leg, and your right foot is going to be fully extended. And make sure you're sliding, not jumping, because when you start jumping and diving in, that's when you get those turf burns and strawberries on your hip. So sliding in and not jumping in. But that is the form of the basic. Now it's time to move on to the next variation, and that is the hook. All right, so the hook is a challenge which isn't always used in the right
situations, the right plays on the pitch. And something that I'm still working with as well is mastering sliding with my left side using the basic instead of my right foot with the hook. And we'll talk more about the pros and cons of the hook, but it's much more effective to use the basic with your left foot than it is to use your right foot with the hook in most plays on the pitch that demand a tackle, a slide tackle, or a challenge.
But the form of the hook is pretty simple to learn and to interpret and then perform in the pitch. All I'm doing is sliding on my right hip. So in comparison to the basic where I'm sliding on my left hip, I'm sliding on my right hip with the hook, but I'm still challenging with my right foot to win the ball. So if I want to clear the ball, it's more of a motion where I'm hitting the ball with my shin, but to possess the ball, the hook motion that is essentially what the tackle is called, I'm trying to form a U shape with my foot to hook the ball away and possess the ball. So again, I'm sliding in with my right hip, with my right leg fully stretched out to form a U shape and hook the ball away and possess it.
But the hook is best used in situations where you're trailing the attacker, where you have to hook the ball away and you're behind the attacker, because you can't use a basic tackle when you're trailing the attacker, if that makes sense. So if you're in front of the attacker or side by side, it's more effective to use the basic, but trailing the attacker, it's more effective to use the hook motion to win the ball or clear the ball away. So that is tackle number two, the hook. Now it's time to move on to tackle number three, the maestro.
Stars fall at my feet, keep me grounded as I reach.
All right, so the maestro, essentially just a modified basic, same form. I'm sliding with my right foot forward, left foot underneath me, but instead of clearing the ball away, I'm going to possess the ball at the inside of my right foot. It's very hard to time this right and get it down to the point where you can possess the ball instead of clearing it. But Nesta mastered this challenge back in 2005 with this absolute brilliant tackle. It's probably the best tackle in the history of the game, guys. No joke. It's just so clean, so concise. But this is the Nesta tackle. Absolutely brilliant, brilliant challenge. Like, the attacker didn't even know what hit him when Nesta slid in there and got the ball. He was so confused and so dumbfounded what even happened. But that is tackle number three. That is the maestro. Now it's time to move on to tackle number four, the lam. All right, so what is a lam? Pause the video right now and guess in the comment section below what a lam is, and see how close you are to getting it right. But a lam is not a llama. It's Philipp Lahm, the German right back and Bayern Munich right back, who actually created this tackle back in the day. I want to say back in 2000, maybe 2005, 2006, he made this challenge world famous.
Some keep a diary, seems like a fantasy, but it may require some love and desire. It's something to cover me.
So what's the form of this tackle, guys? Well, it's basically a modified backward basic. That sounds super complicated, but it's really not that hard to interpret and understand. It's a modified backward basic. So we're going to start out with the opponent on our right shoulder. We're going to lead and extend with our right foot. We're going to have our left leg underneath us to brace us and support us. We're going to slide our left hip. Use our right leg to reach out and extend for the ball, but slide past the ball, don't hit the ball, slide past it, form a V shape with our leg, and then trap the ball with our heel. It's a very, very hard movement to master because your eyes are being taken away from the ball, and you have to know you won the ball before you actually won the ball, if that makes sense. So that is tackle number four, that is the lam. Now it's time for tackle number five, and that is the studs.
So the studs up tackle. This is one that you want to avoid, not at all costs, but something that you should avoid if you can avoid it, as it can cause serious harm to your opponent. So the form, in essence, is the same thing as a basic slide, except that my foot is turned horizontally to have greater surface area to hit the ball, my ankle is locked, and my posture is more upright. If you master this challenge, guys, it's an absolute f***ing brilliant tackle, as it invigorates your teammates, and it looks brutal, but anyone who knows football knows that if you get the ball first, not the man, it's a pretty clean challenge. But that is tackle number five, that is the studs. Now it's time for tackle number six, the company. All right, guys, the last variation of the slide tackle I'm going to talk about today is the company tackle. It's a tackle made famous by Vincent Kompany back in 2009 in a game versus Manchester United.
I seen a lot of shit I shouldn't have, but never forgot it though. Brothers on the corner selling crack like it was not it though. Walk inside my kitchen, baking soda all up on the floor.
So that tackle seems clean, but it's a two-footed challenge, and he got red carded for that challenge. So this is something that I want to talk about just for a minute, and that's thrown in two-footed challenges, guys. Like, you cannot throw two-footed challenges in and expect anything good to happen from it. It's a very dangerous play, and the pressure and the amount of force that's being generated from a two-footed challenge can break someone's leg very, very easily. So do not throw two-footed challenges in. So for obvious reasons, the form of this one is not going to be shown in this video, but just know that, guys, the cleanest of two-footed challenges will get you sent off in a heartbeat. The final thing I want to say, guys, before we end today's video, just to understand the calculated risks aspect. Like, you have to understand what you want to do before you dive in and leave your feet. So know the playing surface, know the tackle you're about to give, know the player you're going up against, know your own speed, your strengths, your weaknesses. That all plays a part in leaving your feet and diving in to win the ball. So do all those things and you have a great chance of throwing in a brilliant slide tackle.
All right, guys, so that's going to wrap up today's video. Hope you liked it. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you smash that like button. Of course, check you guys in the next video. Deuces.